Also speaking up on the latest clash between Manila and Beijing is a former member of the United Nations arbitration panel that invalidated Beijing's expansive claims over the South China Sea. Rüdiger Wolfram urges all states in the region to sit down and seek ways to ease tensions. At a forum organized by the Philippine Foreign Affairs Department and the German Embassy, Wolfram advised Manila against filing a new or supplementary case amid China's defiance of the 2016 arbitral award. He instead urged the country to go for diplomatic efforts.
Whoever will take the lead should ask for establishing such a round table to seek ways out of this growing tension which is existing in the South China Sea. One should first exhaust all efforts of all states of this region to come to a consensual agreement before even considering a new case. A new case would only aggravate probably the situation and would lead at the end of the day to nothing.
Wolfram also calls on media to tone down its language and for politicians to return to international cooperation.
Beijing confirms its Coast Guard blocked. It fired water cannons on Philippine supply boats headed for a Union shoal. But the Chinese Foreign Ministry claims Manila's boats were the ones who trespassed into Chinese waters without consent. It adds the Chinese Coast Guard only performed its official duties with accord or in accordance with law and upheld China's territorial sovereignty and maritime order. Philippine Foreign Affairs Secretary Teodoro Loxin Jr. had condemned China's actions as illegal since it has no law enforcement rights in the area. He also reminded China's ambassador to the Philippines, public vessels are covered by the Mutual Defense Treaty between the Philippines and the U.S. Manila regards the Ayungin Shoal, internationally called the Second Thomas Shoal, as being within its 200 nautical mile exclusive economic zone. National Security Advisor Hermenes Esperon, meanwhile, raised concern over what he says is the unusually large number of Chinese maritime militia in Ayungin Shoal and Pag-asa Island this past week. For its part, Malacanang says the Philippine government will continue to assert sovereign rights and jurisdiction over the country's territory. Philippine Vice President Lenny Robredo consults with retired generals on how to stop Chinese harassment in the South China Sea. Robredo, who is running for president in 2022, says the amount of time needed to plan a Philippine security policy and strategy regarding its maritime and territorial disputes with China must be long-term and sustained, regardless of changes in administration. An outspoken critic of President Rodrigo Duterte's policy of setting aside the Manila's arbitral victory for friendly relations with Beijing, Robredo said the West Philippine Sea issue is non-negotiable. If elected president, Robredo says she is open to working with China. She insists it must first recognize Manila's arbitral win.